Okay, so this is the second layout I'm going to do with the June Clique Kit. Now, before we get started, the last time I did a layout, I totally didn't do it the way I normally do. I just kind of started picking papers and embellishments, and I just found that it took me forever to get that layout done. Not that it took me longer than usual. It just felt like my brain was all over the place. I couldn't focus on what I was doing. It was just all over the place. So what I decided to do is I'm going to walk you through what I normally do. I just have the kit here with all the pattern papers, and we'll put together partial page kits, and then we'll put a page together. So the first page, I brought in my own cardstock, white cardstock, and then I really love that corrugated paper and that pattern paper from Ellie Studio. Really love that. And then I had some leftovers from my last layout that I think I'm going to try to incorporate in there. And then I might use, I don't know, some stickers on here. We will see. And these letters match perfectly. And so that'll be the first. So I'll put that aside, and then we'll just keep putting some pattern papers together and see what I can put together as far as layouts. Oh, I so wish I had two. I could use this and some of that. So we'll put that, maybe this. I think I like that. And then maybe I can cut one of these out. And see if there's any small papers that I could use to mat the thing. So I thought I'd do real time again. Just because the last one I posted, it doesn't feel like that long ago. Like I just posted it at the end of last week. But it was actually filmed like almost 3 weeks ago. I just didn't have a chance to upload it. So I thought, so the update that I said on there was actually 3 weeks ago. Today is August 3rd, I think. 3rd or 4th. And so it was, and that was like probably July 15th. 14th, 13th, or something like that. So it was a long time ago. Okay. So let's put those three together. And then, if you hear some noise there, it's Scruffy. He's, of course, I'm in my room, so he's gotta follow suit. Usually I shut the door, but oh my goodness, it's warm and I can't put the fan on because then you won't hear me. So it is a scorching hot day. We've had an amazing summer, like just beautiful weather all summer, which was kind of good because when you're building a house, that's what you want, because you don't want rain days, especially at the beginning, because then they can't do your house. Which we almost got no delay whatsoever. I think we got 2 afternoons or something like that. That was it. That was it. Oh, like that. So I can. Oh, and I like that too. See, this is where I wish I had 2. Okay, so do I want agree with that? That's too much the same. A little bit more contrast there. a little bit more contrast. The yellow is the same pattern paper, except it's yellow. And then these flowers have some gray, some pink, and some yellow. So we'll put these three together. Don't know if I'm going to use them, but for now, that's kind of what sort of caught my eye. I love this, but I can't find anything else. Actually, I'm going to put the coffee cups with this. I always go see my girlfriend. Well, we try to do often, but life gets in the way. But I'm going to see her tomorrow, so maybe we can do a little selfie. We've never done a little selfie of us having coffee. So maybe we can document our coffee time. So there's these two that's left over. That's fine. So okay, so now I have these. Now the next thing I do is I go through my embellishments and I throw in some embellishments on top of all the pattern papers. So let's do that. Ooh, look. Yay. I wonder if it... Oh, and me and my other girlfriend from work, we're going to see Bad Moms. Oh, it doesn't match. A little bit. We're going to see Bad Moms on Friday. And actually, I'm babysitting Mason tonight so my daughter can go see it. It's at the theaters, so... I haven't gone to the theater with a girlfriend in like, 20 years. Like a long time. And so it'll be fun. I'm looking forward to it. I went to Costco yesterday and I bought the deal that you can get there. And so I think we're going to go on Friday. I think that's the plan. I got to text her today and make sure. But I think... That would be better for me because I think Saturday we want to take Mason to the zoo because we haven't done that yet. And here we are in August and we haven't gone to the zoo. Last year we had gone probably, I don't know, 3 or 4 times already. We haven't even gone once. It's been a crazy summer. And we kind of expected it, you know, being that we are building and everything, but still. Still want to. So we had him last night for a few hours. Kind of, he couldn't, oh, it was so sad. He just cried. He didn't want to go home. He wanted to stay here, but only have a few days off. And we're about a month, I'd say 5 weeks away from moving in. And I haven't finished packing yet. I still have a lot of packing and I have a few days, and if I don't focus on doing that, it's not going to get done. So I can't. So I told him that he's coming tonight for a few hours and then we'll try to take him on the weekend. I just thought I'd do a page first and then I'm going to go and pack quite a few quite a few boxes. I'm packing my scrap room right now and it's like, ugh, so much. And that's why the kits are kind of nice, because then I don't have to worry as much about keeping stuff out so that I can keep scrapbooking. I'm going to put that I'm going to put this on there, but then I can't use it on other layouts. Although I'm going to do this page first. So as long as you do the page in the order that you're... But normally I would cut this apart and then put them with different pages. But I just want to start scrapbooking here. So here. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do it. I'm not going to say this is what I normally do. I'm just going to do it. just gotta unpack some stuff here. Oops. Favorite lip balm. I should invest, you know, in some shares into this because I have so many of them. I have some for every pocket that I own, I think, for jackets, and I use it all the time. It's so dry at work and even at home. Like, I just find, and I was talking to one quite a few years ago, I went to the dentist and he said that your lips can kind of get addicted to it, but this is like a Vaseline, like there's not much to it. But oh yeah, if I don't wear it, like my lips get totally cracked. And there's about four of us at work that use the exact same thing. I can't have anything that's scented. It's got to be unscented. But anyway, totally a rabbit. Ooh, I don't know if you could see that, but my lights there were flickering. So, not good. There you go. This is my Caterpillar crop. And I kind of ruined the blade, but I think it's okay. But I had one of my subscribers say that she went to, what was it? It was like one of the shows, like scrapbooking shows, and Caterpillar was there, and they said that they guarantee their blades for life. So I might contact them because it's still, like, it never used to do this. Now it's leaving little things on my, if I have to do a close cut. Like if I cut like this, it's fine. But if I had some left over and I had to cut it, it would totally leave little nubbits behind, and I don't like that. There, so I'm happy with that. This can go in the first, on the first layout. Now the rest I can just use my scissors and cut them apart. They're not very big, so. And this is my iris tray that I made myself. I do have a tutorial on my website to make your own. It's not hard to do, it's just time consuming. Takes a few hours, but totally worth it. Totally worth it. So I'm going to put that little heart because this is kind of the pink page that I had. And I might, this I don't want to cut because I know I want to use some of this. So I'm only going to cut the ones that I know I'm going to use. And then I can use the pattern paper too. I wish, actually, I was going to contact Erica and see if she could somehow just put me down as on top of my kit to always get the extra pattern paper because I use it. I like having the two pattern papers for sure. So we got that, we got that. And I like that there's a little bit of purple in this. I might try to, I don't know, do a layout where I pull the purple. And that reminds me, I'm working on a class right now. It's almost done, but where it's been so great, like it's done. I'm just working on the last of the videos, like the putting them together and uploading them to my Vimeo account or whatever. And it's how to make the most of a collection when you have a whole collection, and picking out, you know, colors that maybe not be sort of primary in there, and so you, that your collection or your pages don't all look the same, even though you're using the whole the same collection for a whole bunch of pages. So that should be coming out within the next week. I still have like, what day are we today? Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. I start on Monday, so I still have 4 or 5 days off, and I plan on getting a bunch of stuff done. I did sleep in this morning because I was exhausted. After my night shift, I kind of woke up early the next morning, and I usually have to take one day that I sleep in. So this morning I slept until 9. Yesterday I got up at 6. So today I slept in, and then I finished a book I hadn't read in a few days. And I love reading. That's my new sort of, I can't say new passion this year, because I used to read. I used to be such a big reader when I was younger. And then when my kids were younger, I used to read a lot. And then I started scrapbooking, and maybe this with the previous page, the one I just put aside there. I used to read quite a bit. And then I stopped, especially when I got totally into scrapbooking, because that kind of took all my energy kind of thing. Whenever I had a minute, that's what I would do. So now I'm trying to find some time. Instead of what I cut out, and I'll tell you what I cut out, instead of going to bed and watching something on Netflix, I read, or watching videos on YouTube. I've cut down a lot, just because I want to make sure that I'm able to read. I've read 39 books as of today, which is amazing. I just finished the White Hot Kiss trilogy by Jennifer L. Armentrout. That was the first time I read anything of hers, and I enjoyed it. I gave them all 4 stars. And so now I'm going to try and finish, what's it called? The Magnus Bane Chronicles. I'm about 50% done, 59% done or something like that. So I got to finish that off. I always tried to have 2 books on the go. I had a few questions. People were asking whether I read physical books or I read stuff on my Kindle, and I do both. I always have a physical book on the go and a Kindle book on the go. Okay, what did I have that with? This, right? Yeah. I don't know if I like it with that. How about if I go find a cardstock? Maybe like a teal. Yeah, that really makes it pop. So we'll start with that. Because I'm not going to use a big piece of that. I'm just going to use a little bit. We'll see. Or maybe a pink. Pink might be good. Let me see. So what I did was I took a little bit of a whole bunch of different colors and I put it in a drawer next to my desk. And that way I have cardstock that I can use. I think I'm going to go with the pink. I haven't scrapbooked with pink in a long time. And I think there was a piece of vellum, or 2 pieces of vellum. So I'm just going to bring that in. I haven't scrapbooked with pink in a long time. So when I'm packing, then I still have stuff that I can scrapbook with until pretty much the last day before I move into the house. I'm sure there's going to be a gap of, you know, when we actually move in, but we will see. And these, there's a whole bunch of transparencies, but I don't want to throw them on there because we won't see them. And what I'm going to do is, if you have any kind of alcohol inks, so whether it be Copic markers, because there's alcohol ink in that, or the Tim Holtz alcohol inks, you can change the color of those. And you can see here, I changed the color of this one a little bit. I put a little bit of teal on it and it changed the color. So that's what I'm going to do with those. But I'm going to leave them in there because they're so transparent. But I'll use some of that for sure. And where I'm using vellum, then I can use these vellum tags. Ooh, and I like this, little moments. And so that's what I do. I just kind of go through and pick some embellishments and just throw it on top of the page. And then once I feel like I have enough, then I just put it aside and then I start putting the pages together. I'm just going to quickly go through the cards here. I want to try to use them on these layouts because I'm not going to use them any other way. Kind of project life kind of went on the wayside. I think I like this one here for that one, maybe. Yeah, so project life kind of went on the wayside, but I have pictures of every month, so if I want to, I can go back and do monthly pages, sort of what I was doing at the end of the year, because the weekly stuff, that just didn't work for me. It was just too much to do. So, one last page, and then we can start putting a page together. And then this, you can put the whole thing at the end, at the bottom of your iris tray or iris container. Or if you have plastic bags, you can put them in plastic bags. I do both depending on what I feel like. It changes almost weekly, so I like both. I like doing it both ways. I don't know, maybe try to use another tag here. So sort of the what I try to do is make sure that I try to use as much of the kit as I possibly can. So when I'm done doing the pages, I can say, okay, well, that's done. And I don't have to put all this stuff into my stash. It's just used up. Okay, so let's see how many pages we put together. So that's one. I'll probably grab a cardstock for that one. Nope. So I'll try to find a teal or an aqua and put that with there. That's one. Two. I might try to find a light pink for that. Two. Three. Four. And that's five, but we've already done one, so that'll be six. And then once this is all done, then I sort of I hit the reset button, and then I put some more together and then get more pages done. So now we're going to get started with this page. I said I was going to start with the top page first. Those were leftovers. And then we can, while I'm doing the page now, I can chat about what's been going on. Just looking for the photo because I've already printed the photo before I started the video. Where did I put it is another question. Let me see. Did I put it in here? Today is, like I said, a scorching, scorching hot day. Okay. What's the deal? Did I put it with the page already? Oh, here it is. Okay. It's a super small photo, and I printed this with my new Polaroid Zip, and it uses zinc paper, and this is what, there's 50 in here, and it came with 10, and this is what the box looks like. And it's for mobile phones, photo printer. It's zero ink. And the pictures are 2x3, and you have an app, and you can, you know, there's different configuration that you can do the photos. So, yes, thank you, Tracy Banks, for, anyway, she reviewed this on her channel. I'm like, oh, I gotta have it. I love it. It's so cute. I have the LG photo print. The pictures, I think, are a little bigger, and it really looks like a little Polaroid. So this is just a little different. So, and this has, it turns into a sticker. So that's pretty cool. It's a sticker. So that's what's different with the other one too. So I printed it with that. And like I said, where I haven't been around in a bit, I thought I'd kind of give you an update. I went on my Facebook group the other day and just kind of finally added some people that had been waiting, and just kind of gave a brief update of what's been going on in a few words. And so now I said that I would do a video and just kind of let you know what's been happening. So that's what I'm going to do while I do this page. So this is a photo of, again, this year we went to New Hampshire in the White Mountains, and we climbed Mount Washington. My daughter and her fiance couldn't come last year, and they really wanted to go, so we just said that we'd go again. And last year we climbed up and we took the train down. This year we told them, because at five people, $50 each, it would have been $250 for us to come down the hill on the train, or the mountain, not the hill. So we said, if we climb down, we'll go and have a good steak dinner and we'll pay. And so we did. We went up the Amusrustuk Trail or something like that. And then we came down the Jewel Trail. And oh my goodness, I hurt my knee about a quarter of the way down. And it just, from the impact of, because it's all rock, so the impact of your foot hitting was just shooting pain through my knee. So then I started walking sort of on the tip of my toes to try to stop the impact. But then what it did was I injured my toes so bad. Like, I don't know if you can tell there, it's kind of gross. I mean, this is my feet, but my whole toenail is black and it's bruised. It was pooled with like blood underneath and my toes. Thankfully, it only started really, really hurting. We had less than half a mile to do, and I'm like, I don't know what's going on with my toes, but oh my gosh. And so when I came back, there was no way I could stand to scrapbook because it hurt so bad. So then we went to Bed Bath & Beyond. We bought one of those little pool things for your feet, and I put Epsom salt in there, and it really helped. And I mean, my toes are still black as can be, and we've been home for a week and a half. And, but it doesn't hurt anymore. But we also went to Costco and we bought one of those mats, and they're called healthy mats. Actually, just wait a sec. I think it's something that every scrapbooker has to get. It's called an anti-fatigue kitchen mat. But you can put it anywhere, and it's 20 by 42, so it's fairly big, and it feels so, I'm going to get one for my kitchen too, but it feels so good. It takes away pain on your lower back and your legs and your feet, and it's nice and cushiony. So I got one of those for my, I got the brown one for my craft room. So now I can stand on that and my toes don't hurt because it's nice and cushiony. So anyway, so that's the injury that I talked about on my Facebook group. So I just printed off these photos. These is actually my daughter and her boyfriend. When we came down the Jewel Trail, the view was amazing. And I'll be scrapping more photos. But I just printed off. I want to try my little printer. So I printed off that photo on that. And now we're going to start the page. So I'm going to do the whole page on the white cardstock, and I'm going to use that. Let's put the embellishments off to the side. I think I'm just going to use the flowered side. And I'm going to use the corrugated paper too. I'm going to use this as something to mat the photo. Ouch. Just stubbed my toe. Not the best thing to do after you hurt your toes. But... okay. Oh yeah, I don't need adhesive. I can just remove this. And stick it down to my cardstock. Okay. I'm going to cut around it. So, oh my goodness, we had so many adventures, like Mason would say. He's been on an adventure this whole summer, too. And he's all into the adventures. I've never seen a kid that loves to do stuff. Like, he loves to travel. He does not complain when he's in a car because he knows he's going on an adventure and that's all he cares about. And I mean, they went to Newfoundland, which is, they were like, I think it's 7 or 8 hours on a ferry. And he loved it, the whole thing. I'm sure he would do it again. So he loves his little adventures. So, there we go. Start with that. And I think to separate that and that, I'm going to put some of that corrugated paper. I think I might do a little bit of mixed media. I don't know what I'm going to do to the background, but I feel I want to do something. So while I'm cutting this out, a little update on our house. This week, or last week, the end of July, we had the plumber that was there one day and the ventilation guy. Then the plumber finished roughing in. I mean, they got to come back and add the whirlpool when the base is done and stuff for it. And the toilets and all that, you know, the sinks and the finishing work. So they got to come again, but once everything is all done. And then the ventilation guy was there, so he added all the pipes and stuff for the heat pump. Now he's got to wait until we're ready to put in the heat pump and all that stuff. So he's waiting until more stuff is done. And then the electrical guys are in. They're finishing off today. So all my plugs are in. And they were so good. I told them what I was doing upstairs. And instead of, you know, rolling their eyes and, okay, scrapbooking, you know, whatever, he wanted to know exactly what I was going to use it for. And I didn't want to sound like greedy or whatever. So I said, you know, I'll just put this many plugs or whatever. And the next day we went over because he needed us for something. And he said, I added you 3 or 4 more plugs upstairs because I thought about it. And after you told me what it was for, I figured you needed more. So he added more plugs. And he added more lights. So LED lights, I'm going to have like 6 up there, so which is going to be really good for filming and stuff. So that's kind of cool. Oh, I like that. I cut right through that. That's not good. I'll have to try to find the rest of that. Anyway, distracted. So that was kind of neat. So they're finishing off today. And another thing, I told him what I wanted to do, and he made sure that I had my own, like, Ethernet cord instead of just Wi-Fi, because if I want to do, like, live show on Google, you don't want the internet to be dropping every 2 minutes. So So that was nice. That was super nice. And so they're finishing off today. Today's Wednesday. And then tomorrow, the insulation guys are coming. So I don't know how long that's going to take. And then once the insulation is done, I'm thinking next week, they're going to start putting in our sheetrock in, or gyprock, or however you say it. And that's part of the finishing work, right? Woohoo! So once, you know, the sheetrock is in, then I don't know what they're going to do next, whether it's, they're working on our cupboards. We picked out our ceramic floor yesterday. We paid for it, so they ordered it, which I'm so excited. So, you know, there's ceramic in the kitchen and both bathrooms and the laundry room. And then based on that, I had to choose my cupboards and my countertop first. And then once I did that, then I chose my ceramics. And then once I chose my ceramic, then we went and chose the hardwood floors yesterday, which, oh, I just love it so much. It all coordinates really well. And my husband is like, you know what? You're the one for the colors. And really, I don't care. Whatever. You choose. So if it doesn't look good, it's all my fault. he's like, color is your thing. It's so not my thing. So you go for it. So I've been kind of choosing all that kind of stuff, which has been a lot of fun. And I know a lot of people that have built houses before said they would never do it again. Now, I know we will never do it again, only because this is our retirement home. Like, we're 50, right? We're not going to, and it's land that's been in the family, like, forever. So, it's not as if we're going to want to sell that to upgrade, you know? Like, it's going to stay within the family. So, I know we're not going to build again. But if we were young, it's not something that I would say I wouldn't do. And I'm not a shopper at all. At all. I don't even do grocery shopping because I don't like going in stores. But these stores are kind of different. There's usually not a crowd, right? Because when you go to the plumbing place to choose all your stuff, there's not a crowd. You're it. It's you and them. When you go choose your floors, you're it. It's you and them. So there's not like the flurry of a ton of people. So I'm not hating it. So, which is good. But we're almost done. All our electrical stuff is chosen. All our plumbing stuff is chosen. Our floors are now chosen. Now, the only thing I have to do is choose the colors on the walls, which I'm not going crazy. It's going to be mostly neutrals because I figure I'm going to hate anything. You know, I'm going to get tired of something that's a different color. So I'm just going to go neutral. I'm going to go real easy, and then it's going to be easier to sort of match things up. Now, I don't know what I want to use for the background, because I want to do some kind of maybe I can just use this and add water. Let me see. Let me get a piece of packaging. I haven't used the distress inks in a while, so let's do that. Now, I don't want the cardstock to go all wonky wonky, so I am going to put some clear gesso. And with a clear gesso, it doesn't change the color of your paper, whether it's your cardstock or your pattern paper, because it is clear. And I kind of went overboard. It's okay. I'll just spread it as much as I want, and then I'll just open my bottle and put the excess in there. There you go. That's what's nice about using one of these tools too, because you can kind of bring it all to one area. Okay, now my new craft room. I think I'm gonna pretty much bring all the containers or the pieces of furniture, I guess. You know, the recollections, stuff that I had in here. And then I also had, when I first did this room, I did a lot of stuff that would have been like closet organizers. And because that's all they had. They didn't have the recollections. It didn't exist at the time when I did my room. It came out about a year in Canada anyway, like a year and a half later. So I still have a lot of my stuff in my room in that. So I'm going to be bringing that. And the only thing it's in here, it's really quite, like my room is only like, I think, I don't know, 8 by 9 or something like that. Then I have a hallway back there, and then I have a walk-in closet, but it's not somewhere where I can go and stand and do stuff, and I can't make areas. With my new room, I plan on making like areas, so I want to have a place where I'm going to put my die cut machine and like my Big Shot and the Cuddle Bug and all the dies. And then another spot I want to put all my stamps. And then another, oh, there goes my breaker. And that's not going to happen in a new place, because they've put stuff on different breakers, and I won't be, anyway, it shouldn't happen in a new place. Okay, so I don't know how close the color is for this. So I'm going to do it on the back of the cardstock first. So I want to look at the color. It was okay to just, yeah, that's fine. It was okay just to edge the paper because you couldn't really see, but I want to make sure. I'm just going to dry that up. Dry that up so that, there, it doesn't mark that. Oh, look at that, it went through. That's okay. I'm going to put it that way because I know that most of this is going to be covered. Or I'm going to have more colors there too. So it's all good. Now, one of the things I'm going to try and keep out till, like, we're actually got the, or we know, like, in the next 4 days or whatever we're moving, I want to make sure I keep my distress inks out so that I can, just the little ones, these ones here, the mini ones, I want to make sure to keep them out so that I can do other stuff. But I gotta start packing basically mostly my whole room very soon, because 5 weeks goes by pretty quickly, and especially when you work. There we go. I'm gonna finish that off. This is just to add a little bit of color in the background. I might add some modeling paste. And I might add another color, maybe pink, maybe pink. Yeah, sponge sugar is really, I'll pick that up in a minute. I just knocked over my whole iris container. So there's quite a mess there. I had it sitting on my chair. And when I get to grab this, it all flew everywhere. Oh well. No panic. We'll just get it done. Okay. Now. Ooh, I like this. Reminds me of mountains. So what I'm going to do, and where is that little container? This is what I said that I like to mix stuff in. So I'm going to take some modeling paste. This is not the best one. It's super cheap, but I bought it. So I'm going to have to use it. But it's not my favorite. It's super, like, soupy. It's not stiff or anything. Now, I'm going to need some color. I'd like to get this as color, but I don't know if I water it down, if it's going to be enough. Let me see. Maybe I can find it quickly. I have the... have those, the refills, so much easier than trying to do that. So, and I opened up the drawer and there it was, right on top. So I didn't have to, I just keep all my distress inks all together. Ooh, maybe I put too much. I'm just going, well, maybe not. Such a pretty color. So that's what I like to use these for. It's just kind of a little mixing tray. And when it's done, you just chuck it. Or you can clean it up and use it again. But I find I just keep them all when I open like a new kit or whatever. New die cut pack or... I just keep them all and then I just throw them out. At least I got to use them. There, that's good enough. Okay. So that's why I didn't mind doing so much, because I knew that a lot of it would be covered. So now, let me see. I want to do it, or possibly, not necessarily, but possibly where I could maybe do an embellishment cluster. So it'll be part of it. One here. It doesn't have to be perfect. And I'll do one here. There you go. And I was thinking of doing an embellishment cluster up here. So we'll just do a few. Probably on my mat, so I'll have to clean that off. There. Now I'll get some paper towel or some baby wipes. There you go. cleaned up. It's a little messy, but that's the nice thing, is it doesn't have to be perfect. There. So I'm going to clean this off, because otherwise this is going to turn into cement, and it's really hard to get it cleaned up. One thing that I made sure of is in my craft room, I'm going to have a sink so that I can, like stuff like this, I can just have some water in the sink and stick it in. Like if I know I'm doing mixed media, I can put water with soap, stick it in there while I'm doing the page, and then as soon as I'm done, I can go and clean it up. I just, what I did was I put like a laundry tub instead of like a counter, and it was just cheaper to get a laundry tub instead of getting a countertop and separate sink and separate taps, and it's just easier and cheaper. So that's what I did. Okay, so now that has to dry. So I'm going to turn the camera off, and I'm going to let that dry, and then I'm going to come back. And everything's dried up, so we're just going to finish off this page. So we're going to just take everything now and just kind of glue it down, nail it down, something like that. I want to do some journaling, I think. Oh yeah, I think I'll do that sort of on the side there. Okay, let's just ink the edges. It's super warm outside, but I'm freezing. Like my hands are basically blue because I don't know why I'm so cold, but it's like hot outside. I don't know. Hopefully it doesn't mean I'm getting sick. I don't feel like I'm getting sick. I just don't know why I'm so cold. I'm like an icicle. Which doesn't make sense. Which, after I'm done this, I'm going to start packing again. So I'll probably warm up super quick. Because, oh my goodness, it is warm when you're packing up. Ugh. Not. We've been here in this house for 24 years. That's all I'm going to say. So you know. We got crap. So, just my scrap room. I'm starting with that. I know I still want to, you know, play with stuff and that kind of stuff. But I got enough page kits that I put together back in February, I think it was. I think I still have like 20 or so pages left for that. And then I have my June Clique Kit. I have my July Clique Kit. And my August will be coming in soon, right? So I'm not too worried about running out of stuff. I know that I'll be okay. So I'm not worried about that. It's just that it's tools and stuff. You don't want to pack that up too quickly, because then you'll need something and you won't have it. Like, I don't think I want to pack up all my Nouveau glitter drops, or whatever they're called, crystal drops. I don't want to pack those up too soon, because I'm going to want to use them. And I'm going to pack up all my cardstock and stuff, because like I said, I separated some. So now I have just a little bit of, quite a bit of colors. I might not have all the colors, but I'm okay with that. I'm good. I don't care if, you know, the colors are not perfect for a specific layout. I'll just deal, kind of thing. I will just deal. So I don't know if I want to use this at all. I like that it's kind of the flower in big, but might use it here. So I picked up all my mess that I did a while ago, all my embellishments that went flying all over the place. I picked them all up. Of course, there's all those transparent ones. Ugh, those were not fun to pick up at all. But it's picked up. I've dealt with it. So that's good. I don't know if I want to do sort of little steps here. Put down my photo. So again, we had so much fun. I can tell you, when there's a picture that I'm gonna scrap eventually of my daughter, and she's coming down the mountain. And the look on her face was like, okay, I am so done with this. Are we there yet? It just felt forever. We did amazing. We actually shaved 5 minutes from our time going up the mountain. Josh, he shaved 21 minutes because at once we could still see them from, because the top of the mountain's all open, that we could still see them from, you know, quite a ways back. They just booted it to the top of the mountain because they wanted to make sure that they would beat the time that we had set last year, right? And so they, excuse me, they made it to the top of the mountain in 4 hours. And my husband and I, and it was mainly because of me, we made it in 4 hours and 16 minutes, which I was super proud, because last year, although my health was not as good as it is this year. Now this year my vitamin D is super low, or was super low. I haven't gotten it tested lately, but I feel much better. So I'm thinking it went up again, because I'm taking vitamin D every day and I'm going out and sitting in the sun at least 15 to half an hour every day to get some sun, because that's, I read online and they said it's the best vitamin D you can get. You can't overdose on it. So if you can do that, sort of number one. So the fact that I wasn't on the treadmill. Last year I was on the treadmill every day for an hour for like 7 months before we went. So I wasn't surprised that I was able to climb the mountain in the time that we did. But this year I didn't go on the treadmill, and I was like, yeah, we're not even gonna come close to anything that we did last year because I wasn't on the treadmill. But we shaved 5 minutes off, so I was super, super happy about that and impressed that I was able to do that, because I really didn't think that I was going to be able to. I mean, it was challenging, I have to say. It, you know, it wasn't easy by all means. We absolutely loved it. It was like, for my daughter and her boyfriend, fiance, it was their first time and they had a ball. They loved it. And we were there for, I think we only went, we were there, we arrived in New Hampshire on Sunday and we came home on Friday. So I mean, Sunday we got there like at 8 o'clock, so it was kind of late. So we had Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then we came home on Friday first thing in the morning as soon as we woke up. So we were only there 4 days. We weren't going to go at all because we were building, but we had kind of told them that we were going to go, and my husband just needed to go and do something fun. So we only did 4 days just to kind of, you know, keep it low in cost. And we didn't do much shopping at all. Like, they did a little bit of shopping. We got a few hoodies for my son, and that was about it. We didn't even get him sneakers this year. We'll just get them around here. And I think we bought more stuff at the top of the mountain than we did anywhere else. And because they have little, you know, gifts, and we bought Mason a full length sweater up there, or shirt, I should say. And we got him a hat because he loves like baseball caps, loves those. So we got him one of those from the top of the mountain. And we bought myself a hoodie and Josh a hoodie and my husband a t-shirt and little things like that. I actually got a flare button, which was kind of neat. So I'm going to be using that on one of the layouts for climbing the mountain. So that was kind of fun. And then we climbed the mountain down. And like I said at the beginning, that's where I actually hurt. I hurt my my knee. And the funny thing is, like I said, there is so many stories. My family said that the reason that these things keep happening to us is so that I have stories to tell you guys. Because we had so many things happen to us. It wasn't even funny. It was like, okay, enough. But anyway, so as we're doing the pages of my vacation, or as I'm doing the pages of my vacation, I'll let you guys in on this, you know, everything that happened on our vacation. We were only gone 4 days, so, but super, like I said, a lot of fun. And but it was just funny that that many things happened in 4 days. And then my daughter's like, so Mom, this is all your fault, because you need stories, you know, or they enjoy your stories on your YouTube channel. So all these things are happening to us because of it. And, but it was still a lot of fun. I'm going to make this look like it's a little pocket. And then I'm going to put that little tag in there, and I'm going to put some twine, and there was some little twine in the kit too. So it'll give me a place to use. Oh, actually, I think what I'm going to do is I have this twine here, and it matches or coordinates with this page so good. So now tonight I'm going to try and edit this video. This is Wednesday. I thought I was going to be able to get it done a little earlier, but so many decisions to make again this week. So we've been going, and my husband just called and he said, oh, we need to choose the stone that goes in the front of the house. So, and tonight we have to go choose, because we're in the country, so we don't have city water. So now we have to go choose where they're going to put our well. So we got to go do that tonight. Excuse me. We got to go do that tonight. And we have Mason tonight, so he'll come with us. He loves to go see the new house. The only thing, it makes me really nervous because the walls aren't finished, because they're doing, like right now, they're doing the electrical work and the plumbing and all that stuff. So there's walls. So where there would be a wall so that you can't fall down into the basement, where the stairs go down to the basement, there's no wall. So makes me nervous to have him around there. And we keep telling him that he has to hold hands the whole time. And but he's three, right? And he's excited and he wants to. So it just makes me a little nervous to have him there. I'll feel better once the walls are up, because then then it'll be like we're living there. And then once we're living there too, we can tell him, you know, like you can go to here and you have to stop because we don't want you to fall down the stairs. And, you know, he is 3 and a half, so he's really good with stairs. But right now, when there's like just unexpected, you know, something that you can fall through, he is only 3. Like the other night, we had people and my husband's family from out west. They were visiting, so they came to see, you know, how far the house was and all this stuff. And we were upstairs in my craft room, and we were kind of talking about stuff. And I almost started backing up I started backing up like I was going to lean up against the wall. And then I realized, oh my goodness, there's no wall there. So even as an adult, I almost made the mistake of, you know, falling over. I didn't come close or anything because I caught myself. But a three-year-old might not do that. So makes me a little nervous. So kind of have teal going on here. So I'm kind of wondering if I should bring in maybe a little bit of pink. A little bit of pink to because there's a little bit of pink everywhere. This I can put maybe the date here. 2016. And here I'm just going to put the story about my poor toes. And I tell you, I don't know if I told you where I got the mat, but it was at Costco. And they're amazing. And I think they were 20, well, in Canada, it was $29. So 30 bucks, 29 something. So $30. But it's amazing. Like already I'm noticing a difference. That it's easier for me to stand. So I'm happy about that. I think I'm going to put it in the middle. I don't think I'm going to put July. I'm just going to put 2016. And maybe here I can put Mount Washington. Yeah. Let's put it on wax paper first so I can see how it's going to end up. I love those little alphas. So yeah, I'm kind of putting off packing. Ugh. Not looking forward to it. I got quite a bit done, but it doesn't look like I got anything done, if you know what I mean. My scrap room still looks as full as it was. So, not. So today, after I'm done this, I'm hoping to get maybe like 10 boxes. That's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to say I'm going to do 10 boxes a day or 10 boxes in the morning and then this many in the afternoon and try to get it done. I have two more rotations and then I'm off for a month. And I don't know if the house is going to be done in that time. But at least I know it should be pretty close. And at least I know I can get all my packing done. So when the house is done, I can just say, boom. Everything is packed, you know, except whatever we need, like for the kitchen and stuff like that, like to live. And then we can just move whenever. So I'm taking time off to pack. And then once we're in the new house, I think what we're going to do, not I think, this is what we're going to do. We're going to put, when we move, we're going to put all our boxes in the basement. And then every night, like on my days off, which I'm hoping that some of that month will, I'll be able to start putting boxes away. But I'll get my husband to bring up, I don't know, 5 boxes or 10 boxes or whatever the amount of boxes that I think I can put away in one day in the kitchen or on the main floor, and then X amount for my craft room. And I'm going to have to do my main floor stuff, like our house stuff first. But I don't want to do all of that in none of my craft room because that'll drive me crazy. And I got to have some rewards, right? So then I'll say, okay, as I got to put those 10 boxes or 15 boxes, whatever, decide, away first. And then once that is done, then I can sort of go play in my craft room and put away however boxes I asked him to bring up. And I want to make sure that I organize stuff the way I want them from the beginning. So it might take me a little longer, but then everything will be the way I want to. Now I counted yesterday, and I think, well, it was really close. I think it was like 68. I have 68. Oh, look, that fits perfectly. 68 of those containers from Michael's. And then I have other containers too. Or, like I said, it was like closet organizers. So I have to sit down and sort of work out a plan on how I'm going to arrange everything and sort of have the layout of my craft room and start planning where I'm going to put stuff. Because when I worked at the scrapbook store, she had those metal cubes that you can buy, like made out of wire, and you have like four, and then if you bought extras, you could do like shelves. She had a whole bunch in the store and she was selling them, and I bought a whole bunch and I built myself a little tower, or two towers next to each other, and that's where I put my cardstock. So now I got to figure out, okay, where am I going to put that so that it's sort of away from the window so that my cardstock doesn't fade, because right now in my room it's way at the back and there's no sun there, so it's doing pretty good with not fading. Because I used to be a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, so I have a ton of cardstock, and that's going to be my goal when I get into the new house, my new scrap room. I'm going to go through stuff and say, okay, now, you know, here are some of the cardstock that I have to use. So I have to either use them on a background to, as a second background, you know, like to kind of mat the whole layout, or I got to use them to mat my photos, or whatever the case may be. But I gotta get that used up. Okay. I think I'm going to pop this on some foam tape. Yeah, I got to get some of these cardstock used up. I have too many. And I find that now, but I don't want to get rid of it because I know I can use it. And it's the same with all my pattern papers and stuff. Once I'm in the new room, I'll do a tour. But even though it's older stuff, I don't mind. Like those 100 pages that I put together, a lot of that was really old stuff, and the layouts that came out of those, I absolutely love. So I don't mind using older stuff. Okay, so one thing I want to put on here is ouch, ouch, ouch. Because man alive, did I say that a lot. Ouch. Going up is really hard, like on your breath, like you just feel like you're out of breath the whole time because it's like up and up and up, and it's like hard physical work. Going down, I wasn't out of breath once, like, but it's really hard on your joints and obviously your toes, especially the way because I was being careful not to hurt my knee. So I ended up hurting my toes, but next time I will know. We're gonna do it again. That did not deter me from not wanting to do it again. But one thing is for sure, my girlfriend and I, we go, maybe, you know, 2 or 3 times a year to get a pedicure done. I won't be going for a while. Because, oh my goodness, yeah, no. That's right. That's the first thing I said when I said, yeah, I won't be going for a pedicure for a while. Because this is not funny. But that little bath thing, I can't even remember what they're called, but it's amazing. It has 3 or 4 speeds or 3 or 4 buttons. One is for the bubbles. Another one's kind of vibration, and the other one is heat. So what I did, and then I would put Epsom salts in there, and I would put the water on, and I'd leave it cold at first. So then I would soak in 15 minutes with cold, and then I would put heat for 15 minutes. Like, I would take my feet out for a while because I found it was too long. And then a little bit later, then I would do hot, and then I would do cold again. Oh, I pulled this. It was crooked, and I was trying to fix it, and I pulled it right off, which is fine. Where'd it go? Just means I have to add adhesive to it. And just some little misses this to that dots from American Crafts, because I pulled the sticker part right off. Okay. Still think I want to put maybe a little bit of pink, but there's not that many embellishments left. Yeah, so this, I got 2 kits up to now from Clique Kits. And I'll keep getting them until I'm in the house, and then I'll make the decision. I think once I start unpacking stuff and I maybe see how much stuff I have, I might change my mind and say, yeah, I need to use what I have. And then it'll be organized more, so I'll probably make kits, page kits, like I did back in March. Now, one thing that's new, and I haven't had a chance to talk about it, is I'm on the creative team for Get It Scrapped, and my first layout should have, I think, went up like at the end of July. I have a video for it, I just haven't had the chance to edit it and put it up, but that's one thing I want to work on this week. So you should get a couple of videos from me. That video for Get It Scrapped and this one. So that's super exciting. My second assignment is due in the middle of August here. So yay. Or, wait a second. No, my first... My first will just be at the end of August, because we're a couple of months, like, they want stuff done like a month ahead. So yes, I can't put up that video yet. It's a good thing I thought of it. So I still have to work on that video though and get it ready so that when it's time. But they said that we could announce it, so it's not as if I'm letting anything out of the bag. But I have a video coming up for that in the next couple of weeks. So I'll be uploading that on my YouTube channel, and then the page and everything, it'll be on the Get It Scrap blog, and hopefully I'll put it too on my website so that you can kind of see it everywhere. Plus there's going to be a video on YouTube of the process. So that was fun. So yeah, I got to get my second assignment done soon. That's what I got to work on very soon, because I like to get it done ahead of time, because life has been a little crazy lately. But I think they were announcing who was on the creative team in July anyway. But they did say that it wasn't a big secret and we could go ahead and share. So, okay, maybe I can use the love or the sweet. It wasn't really sweet. I mean, it was sweet. I loved the walk and everything. If you can call it a walk, it was more like a, it was quite the adventure. So that whole day, it took me a little longer to get down the mountain because I was injured. So it took us 4 hours and 16 minutes to go up, and it took a little bit over 5 hours to come down because I was injured. So, oh, but it was, like my daughter would say, good times, good times. So this is nice too, that that little sticker thing there, or the die cut, says good times, because she always says that, good times, good times. There, we had a few adventures going down the mountain too, which, like I said, I'll talk about as I'm getting to those pages. But a few adventures, few story worth adventures. A lot of fun. That's pretty much all we did. We went one day, we went because there's a lot of outlets there. So we went to the outlets and I didn't buy anything. The only thing I bought that day was actually at Dunkin' Donuts. I got a t-shirt, which I love. I love t-shirts. That's all I wear. So I bought a t-shirt from Dunkin' Donut and Dunkin' Donuts, and that was the only thing I bought that day. There was no scrapbooking stores there, so there was no scrapbooking to be bought. Which on the way in, we stopped at the first exit in the States is at Holton. And so we went to the Walmart there. We always stop, you know, we have to gas up and everything. So we stop at Walmart, and there was some scrapbooking stuff there. So I bought stuff there, and that was the first day in. And that was the only thing that I bought. And I'll do a share, like a haul of what we bought. And then on the way home, we stopped at AC Moore, and I didn't buy anything. We stopped there for my son because he wanted the Spectrum Noir markers because he likes to draw, and now he's into coloring because his friend from school, she loves to color in with the markers, so she kind of got him convinced to try them out. So, and we got at AC Moore, and they were on for a good deal, so we got a bunch there. We got all the colors actually because they were on for 50% off, so I figured it would be a good time to get them because they were such a good deal. But I'm going to do a page on that too, because it was kind of funny that, you know, we went to a scrapbooking store. And yeah, everyone was surprised that I didn't get anything. I was like, no, I'm good. I was really good. I was okay. And I ordered some stuff, and it's the new Rangers to make enamel dots. So I ordered that. So that should be coming in the next couple weeks. That's it. I am going to order, because there's a whole bunch of new collections that came out at CHA July. And of course, I'm going to get the Dear Lizzie, the Amy Tangerine, and the Chamel probably. I'm going to get those just because they're my favorite. So I'm definitely going to get those. I'm just going to put a few dots here and there. The only thing you got to watch with that is make sure that you don't put your hands over it after. You got to let it dry. So I think my son is finally awake. It's like 2:30 in the afternoon. Teenagers, right? Sleep, stay up super late, and then they sleep all day. Okay, well, that's pretty much the page is done. Cool. So that's the second layout that I got done using the Click Kit. I don't think there's anything else. Like, there's something around here. There's nothing around anywhere else, but that's okay because it's my only round thing. And I just want to bring in some more of those butterflies, but there's no other butterflies, I don't think. I don't think. So this is what fell on the floor a while ago. I was like, really? Here, there's a butterfly like that. Let's try to color it using some alcohol inks. Okay. So, what color? No. Okay, so this is BG13. It's called mint green. Let's see if we can change it or color it enough that's going to make a difference. That you can actually see the... Okay. Maybe the Tim Holtz alcohol ink maybe would work a little better because there might be a little bit more deeper colors, but I think this will be okay. And the more you put on top, like layers, it'll be a little deeper and deeper. There, that's fine. Now how am I going to get that to stay down there? I wonder if I could reach the stapler in there. Or I could just put glue. And the glue is going to dry clear, so if I can get it to just stay. Yee. So I'm sure you guys have heard of the app Pokemon Go, which I'm going to do a layout too for that. Anyway, my son got some Pokemons on the way going up the mountain. So I'm going to do a page about that for sure. So that worked. What I might do is still put a staple in there just so that it stays. Now that's done. I added that. I feel okay. There's like butterflies here in this corner, butterflies here, and butterflies here. There's only one round thing, but it's just one. So I'm okay with that. And then I added enamel dots on here. And my title is in a few places. I got favorite here, and then I got ouch, ouch, ouch. And I'm gonna do my journaling here. And this is cute. I mean, it's not going to have anything on there, but it's just an interactive little tag there. And that's it. That's going to complete this layout. So thank you so much for watching. Bye.